بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله رب العالمين، ثم الصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين حبيب إله العالمين بالقاسم المصطفى محمد. Dear viewers, السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Alhamdulillah, by the grace of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we have started this series of the interpretation commentaries of the Holy Quran, starting with the first chapter of the Holy Quran, inshallah. We'll continue to the last chapter, inshallah. We are still within the introduction to this series. We asked in the previous episode that why do we need to go back to the Holy Quran for every problem that we have, for every challenge that we face? Why do we need to go back to the Holy Quran? There's a beautiful hadith by Rasulullah Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alayhi, which states, what will this Quran do to us if we take it as a guide? This is the important part. If we take it as a guide, not only leaving the Quran on the shelves, respecting the Quran, making sure that the Quran doesn't fall on the ground, make sure no kids touch it, and we come to it once a year during the month of Ramadan, making sure that we read it cover to cover, understanding it or not understanding it, but we make sure we read it. This is not the purpose of the Holy Quran. The purpose of the Holy Quran, it's much, much, much greater than only reading within the holy month of Ramadan, cover to cover, and then we leaving it until the next month of Ramadan. Rasulullah says, "Man ja'alahu amamah, qadahu ila al-jannah." Whoever places Quran in front of him, takes him as a guide, a true guide, will be always in the front, walks and goes in the, to the goes, and we go behind him. Because and we probably have, when we go to someone's house, and based on respect and formality, they tell us, okay, you go in. We tell them, you know the way, you lead, you go, and we follow. That should be our perspective when we get to the Holy Quran. Every minute of our life, every day of our lives, every month, every year, every second, we have to leave the Quran to the front of us. We tell the Quran, you lead, you take us, and we will follow. Not we say to the Holy Quran with our action, verbally, we don't unfortunately communicate with the Holy Quran this way. We don't say to the Holy Quran, okay, Holy Quran, you stay on the shelf, inshallah, next Ramadan, I'll see you. No, we don't say it, but in our action, some of us, not all of us, unfortunately, some of us, we leave the Quran on the shelf until the next Ramadan. Rasulullah says, "Man ja'alahu amamah." Whoever places the Holy Quran in front of him, what will happen? What will be the result? What will be the conclusion? Where this Quran will take us? Qadahu ila al-jannah. It will guide us. It will take us. It will lead us to the heaven. Don't we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala all the time, "Oh Allah, we want to inshallah end up in heaven." Everything that we do from the wajibat and obligatory acts, we do it so, inshallah, we will end up in heaven. And all the sins that are there that we don't commit and we get away from it, it's for us to again end up in heaven and not end up in hellfire. مَنْ جَعَلَهُ أَمَامَهُ. If you place Quran in front of you to lead you, to take you, as we said in the previous episode, it has solution for every problem and challenge that we face within our lives. And Rasulullah continues, وَمَنْ جَعَلَهُ خَلْفَهُ. And whoever places Quran behind him, سَاقَهُ إِلَى النَّارِ. This will guide him, this act of him putting Quran behind his back will guide him to hellfire. وَهُوَ الدَّلِيلِ يَدُلُّ عَلَى خَيْرٍ سَبِيلٍ. This is the guide. Quran is the guide which will guide us to the right path, to the best path, the most convenience and easiest path to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Definitely, I mean, you are completely aware that we mean Quran and Ahlul Bayt alayhim as-salam. One of the meanings that I was reading within the commentaries of وَمَنْ جَعَلَهُ خَلْفَهُ سَاقَهُ أو وَمَنْ جَعَلَهُ أَمَامَهُ قَادَهُ إِلَى النَّارِ, it's that if you remember within the first episode, we mentioned that we should not get to Quran having something in our mind. basically we put our Quran behind us as a backing our point of view, backing our perspective, backing our agenda, backing our ideology. No, Quran should be in the front of us. For example, I remember one day I was surfing the Facebook. I was going and I saw a post from a sister that she brought a verse of the Holy Quran that talks about the hijab. She's not wearing hijab herself. I'm not saying right or wrong right now. We're just trying to analyze this hadith and bring it to the life of our talk. She said, "Well, this verse, from my understanding, was revealed about the wives of the Prophet, and it's about those people, those women who lived 1400 years ago. It's not about us this day and age in the 21st century." So she has an ideology that hijab is not wajib, and it's about people who lived during the life of the Holy Prophet. So she has this ideology, she has this concept, she has this belief, and she comes and she puts Quran behind her back, and she wants to prove her point that Quran does not say anything about hijab. If it says anything, it's about the people who lived during the life of the Holy Prophet. This verse, this hadith says, وَمَنْ جَعَلَهُ خَلْفَهُ وَجَعَلَهُ خَلْفَهُ سَاقَهُ إِلَى النَّارِ. Don't come to the Quran trying to find verses that will prove your point of view, that will prove your ideology, that will prove your argument. Not having complete understanding of the Holy Quran and the hadith of Ahlul Bayt alayhim as-salam, we see, unfortunately, many people argue and have a very strong argument to themselves, and they say, okay, well, this verse of Quran said so and so, this hadith said so and so. Well, have you read the complete Quran? Do you understand the complete Quran? First of all, they don't speak Arabic. They don't understand Arabic. They cannot read Arabic. So they read a translation, which some of the translation, if, let's say some of them, not most of them, they have not done justice. Not that the translators were bad. No, Arabic language and the word of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in Arabic format, still people have a hard time understanding it. That's why we need the kalam and the words of Ahlul Bayt alayhim as-salam. Right now, I read the Quran, 1 or 2 or 3 or 5 or 10 or 100 verses of the Holy Quran in English, which I'm not sure if I have understood it completely. Then I bring those verses of Quran to prove my point to someone. If this is halal or haram, well, Quran said so and so. And if you remember, our first action plan from the previous episode was that we should not interpretate the Holy Quran, the verses of Quran, based on our understanding. We should refer to those scholars who have interpreted the Holy Quran based on the narrations of Ahlul Bayt alayhim as-salam. So an action plan, the second action plan will be, our action plan for this episode will be, inshallah, that everything that we want to say, we make sure we find in Quran solution for this issues that we have, and we won't go anywhere else. We will leave Quran in front of us. We will place the Quran in front of us as a guide. We'll ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the Quran, the words of Ahlul Bayt alayhi wasalam, you lead us. Take us anywhere you want me to be, O Quran. Again, with understanding of the whole, by the understanding of the narrations of Ahlul Bayt alayhi wasalam. This is very important. It is very, very critical that we place Quran in front of us and we follow the Holy Quran. We follow the verses of Quran. That requires what? That requires for us to understand the Holy Quran, to understand its meanings, to understand its interpretation and commentaries of the Holy Quran. That is why this endeavor is coming to you, dear viewers, brothers and sisters. We are trying to, because again, as we have said in the promo and within the first episode, that many youth argue that we don't have an access to an English interpretation of the Holy Quran. How can we leave Quran in front of us, we place Quran in front of us for it to lead us where we don't find the Quran? You have a point. Inshallah, you will follow us within every of these lectures that inshallah will bring the words of Ahlul Bayt alayhim salam that explains the Quran so we have more understanding. And we see that within the hadith of Ahlul Bayt alayhim salam, where Imam al-Baqir alayhi salam says, إِذَا حَدَّثْتُكُمْ بِشَيْءٍ, if I told you something, if I stated in a statement, فَاسْأَلُونِي مِنْ كِتَابِ اللَّهِ, ask me where did I find this, and I will tell you, this is the verse that I am referring to. The words of Ahlul Bayt alayhim as-salam was all based on the Quran. Action of Ahlul Bayt alayhim as-salam, it was all based on the Holy Quran. They were the spoken Quran. Every movement, every gesture, everything that they uttered, it has based in the Quran. Because Imam said, إِذَا حَدَّثْتُكُمْ بِشَيْءٍ, if I said anything to you, فَاسْأَلُونِي مِنْ كِتَابِ اللَّهِ, ask me where I got this from the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and I will bring the book of Allah as a reference. So it is very, very important. Rasulullah also states, إِنَّ هَذَا الْقُرْآنَ مَأْدَبَةٌ لِلَّهِ فَتَعَلَّمُوا مَأْدَبَتُهُ مَاسْتَطَعْتُمْ. Rasulullah states that this Quran, it's like a feast, a dinner table. It's مَأْدَبَة within the Arabic grammar, and it's the meal that they prepare for the newlywed couple. The morning after newlywed couple, they get married and they are together. The next day, within the Eastern culture, they prepare a good meal for them, a good breakfast, which has everything in it that you can, one can imagine. So Rasulullah says, "Inna hadha al-Qur'an ma'adabatullah." This is the feast that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has brought for you. Fata'allamu, learn it. Fata'allamu ma'adabatahu mastata'tum. As much as you can learn from this Qur'an, as much as you can take from this Holy Quran. Don't pick and choose. Just take as much as you can. For example, you've been fasting all day and you've been invited to someone's house and they have 20 to 30 different kinds of foods, fruits, desserts, all whatever you can imagine, it's there. You just come there and you just take a piece of bread and you just say, okay, this is enough for me. Rasulullah says, take from the Quran as much as you can. Another hadith, we are bringing narrations that emphasizes the importance of reading Quran and paying attention to Quran and understanding from Quran and applying the teachings of the Holy Quran. Imam Sadiq alayhi salam narrates, this is in Tafsir al-Ayyashi, volume 1, page 5, where Imam says, عَلَيْكُمْ بِالْقُرْآنِ فَمَا وَجَدْتُمْ آيَةً نَجَى بِهَا مَنْ كَانَ قَبْلَكُمْ فَعْمَلُوا بِهِ. Imam says, take care of the Quran. Learn from the Quran. Be with the Quran. Understand the Quran. Try to ponder on the verses of the Holy Quran. And look at the verses of Quran. Every verse that you see that brings the stories of a nation that they did something and they were rescued, apply those. وَمَا وَجَدْتُمُوهُ حَلَكَ مَنْ كَانَ قَبْلُكُمْ فَاجْتَنَبُوهُ. If you find a story that has a lesson about a group of people that they did something that they were destroyed, don't do it. Basically, what we do for our kids, if somebody did something wrong and fell into trap of something and they face a challenge, we tell our kids, well, if you do this, this is the challenge that you will face. For example, very, very tangible. If we have our kids eating a lot of candies and sugar, and we see somebody has diabetes, we tell them, see, this one, maybe he didn't eat that much candies or he didn't eat that much sugar, but he has this illness in him. We say, see, he ate a lot of candies, a lot of sugar, and he has diabetes. If you eat a lot of sugars and a lot of candies, you will get diabetes. So Imam saying, for the lack of a better term, see the Quran, see the verses of Quran that talks about those people who did something and were successful and were victorious and they attained and achieved their goal, do what they did. And if you saw a group of people within the Holy Quran, their story has been mentioned, they are going completely against the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and they were destroyed, do not apply those verses, those actions that they did. Another hadith that Imam says, إن الله لم يدع شيئا يحتاج إليه الأمة إلى يوم القيامة إلا أنزله في كتابه. What a beautiful hadith. What an amazing hadith. Where Imam says, Allah has not left anything within the Holy Quran until the Day of Judgment. Anything that we are in need of it. any problem that we face, any challenge that we face, any difficulties that we go through, until the day of Qiyamah, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has brought its solution within the Holy Quran. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has not left anything that His Ummah, this nation, it's in need of it until the day of Qiyamah, the day of judgment, إِلَّا أَنْزَلُهُ فِي كِتَابِهِ, except that He brought it within the Holy Quran. وَبَيَّنَهُ لِرَسُولِهِ, and He explained it to the Holy Prophet. وَجَعَلَ لِكُلِّ شَيْءٍ حَدًّا, and He placed for everything a limitation. This is the limit. وَجَعَلَ عَلَيْهِ دَلِيلًا يَدُلُّ عَلَيْهِ, and He brought us, He placed for us guidance which will teach us and guide us to the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, where He wants us to be for our own benefit. Let me open a parenthesis here before I go to the next hadith. We have to really keep this in mind. By us following the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which is the Rasulullah, the path of Rasulullah, the Quran and Ahl Bayt alayhi salam, we are not doing them a favor. Some people, when they do something for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they look at the sky and they say, "Oh Allah, did you see this? I did this for you." We must do everything qurbatan Allah ta'ala, no doubt. Seeking nearness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, no doubt. But we should not have the mindset and the mentality that we are favoring Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that we are favoring Rasulullah, that we are favoring Ahlul Bayt alayhi salam. We are not. By us following the right path, we are favoring ourselves. We're doing something good for ourselves. These are hadith of Ahlul Bayt that they try to push us toward, and there are a tremendous amount of narrations I found, but for the short period of time that I have, I brought only a couple of them, how much we see within the narrations of Ahlul Bayt alayhi salam that they emphasize on Quran, go back to the Quran, read the Quran, understand the Quran, memorize Quran, try to bring it into your lives, and so on and so forth. So we are not favoring them. So the action plan of this episode will be, we will place Quran in front of us to lead us, and we make sure we follow Quran by our action, not only by reading Quran and putting on a shelf. No, we will dedicate inshallah every day at least bare minimum, where Imam says at least read 50 verses of the Holy Quran. We read it in Arabic and also a page or two in English translation, trying to as much as possible, inshallah, to understand the Holy Quran. We conclude this episode by asking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to hasten the appearance of our beloved Imam Mahdi, ajalallah ta'ala farajah sharif. Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Allahumma kun li waliyika al-Hujjat ibn al-Hasan, salawatuka alayhi wa ala abaih, fi hadhihi as-sa'ati wa fi kulli sa'ah, waliyan wa hafiza wa qa'idan wa nasira wa dalilan wa aina, hatta tuskinahu ardaka taw'a wa tumatta'ahu fiha tawila, bi rahmatika ya arhamar rahimin.